self-awareness. And you mentioned a few times about things that you've learned about life on the field. And it's interesting to say that because for me, just living is like being in school. And Earth is a classroom. And I know there's a lot of people who have that philosophy. But what I recognize is that we kind of have different classrooms. So some people, for instance, we all have to learn how to follow directions. Some people learn it from their parents. Some people learn it in classrooms. Some people learn it on the American football field. Mm-hmm. Some people learn it on the global football field. Some people learn it in the military. But we have all these life lessons to learn. Following directions, teamwork, patience, all of those mm-hmm. things. What are some of your self-awareness, some of the life lessons that you learned by playing this sport?
Oh man, yeah, so you definitely named a few of them. I'll say a couple. I'll start with the one that's definitely helped me the most. Organization.
Really?
Organization. I'm somebody that naturally have always been unorganized.
Okay.
You know, whether it's my room mm-hmm. or the way I interact with my group of friends.
Okay.
You know, as I played more and more as a professional more so, mm-hmm. I realized the importance of an organization, whether again it being material things or the people that are involved with you're involved with in your life, and it humbled me and put me in a place where I was allowed to be part of a group and provide impact.
Okay.
Not want to be the main person, mm-hmm. not fall too low and be the shy one,
right.
But recognize the group dynamic, and instead of pointing outward and judging,
yes.
seeing how I can provide impact to make the group better.
Yeah.
That's something that with soccer is very important.
It's huge.
In every game, you know, one day you're playing bad, but you want to be able to count on your teammates mm-hmm. to pick you up.
Yeah.
Some days you're playing very well and your teammates might not be picking up on their part.
Mm-hmm.
It's managing those moments, those imbalances that not only on the field, but in life, truly helps you grow.
Yeah.
See what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
So yeah, organization is definitely the main thing. The next one I'll say is more of a fun one, but it's just creativity.
Okay.
See, a lot of times, you know, you mentioned direction, and it becomes tough for us as people to find the middle ground before completely following direction, but having our own personality evolve
yes.
as well.
Yes.
And the type of player I am, I'm gonna follow the directions.
Mm-hmm.
You know, going back to I recognize the group, but I do see the moments where I can invoke my own creativity.
Yes.
You know, it's just like in life.
Yeah.
You follow the directions, you know, in the right manner, but when the opportunity presents itself for you to let your light shine,
yes.
you gotta take the opportunity.
Yes.
That's something that with soccer, I found myself finding a lot of metaphors
nice.
In life as well.
Nice. It's so funny you say that, because oftentimes I'll tell people, tell me what the standard is. Like, mm-hmm. show me the format, so then therefore I know how many deviations I'm gonna go from it.
Yep.
And that's the creativity piece, mm-hmm. that piece that makes it uniquely you. As you said, it also made me think about the Pele movie.
Oh.
Did you say that?
Great movie.
It is.
And imagine if you had a whole society that grew up.
Mm-hmm.
Pele was centered towards soccer, and you just see the greatness that he achieved,
yes.
and on the outside, the impact that he had.
Mm-hmm.
Now imagine if you take that into school, that mindset, and you allow kids to express their creativity,
yes.
you know, in whatever it is that they choose to do.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think that will really change a lot of things for not only us adults,
yes.
you know, but the world around us. We're obviously in different generations per se, but
mm-hmm.
as we grow, every generation is learning from the one behind them.
Yes.
You know, so it's important that we continue to kind of, you know, push the ceiling and, you know, set up an environment for our youth to want to be creative and
mm-hmm.
to want to maximize their potential.
Yeah, yeah. And we also have to make sure to utilizing the concept of Sankofa. making sure that they're looking back and taking the greatness from behind them,
mm-hmm.
the history, those that
yeah.
came before them, right? Applying it to today to make today better, but also then applying it to the future to make the future greater.
Beautiful.
You know I'm all about the greatest.
Oh, the greatest. The greatest. What y'all know about the greatest?
You better call and ask somebody. You know, one of the things that we're going to talk about, we're going to take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, I would like you to talk to the audience about transitioning from like high school play to college play to then professional
mm-hmm.
play. And then we're going to talk about what you also do off the court, which is very, or off the field rather, excuse me, which is very, very important. All right. We'll be back in a moment on Dr. Walls and Friends.